Fashioned police work may have saved a Treasure Coast senior's life, but investigators say it doesn't have to be that difficult. 84-year-old Agnes DeMaio walked off before dawn from her home in the Vista St. Lucie retirement community. In less than 2 hours, Deputy Sean Masters and his K-9 partner Gunner tracked the woman's scent over several buildings before finding her. Deputies say this case is a good opportunity to let you know about a free locator bracelet program called Care Track. It can make a big difference in cases like this.
We're fortunate this time, but in St. Lucie County, we do have programs called the St. Lucie Locator ID Bracelet Program. The technology is actually based off of technology used to keep track of wildlife. This technology has been around since the 1970s.
Well, all St. Lucie Sheriff's Office K-9 units are trained on the radio-based system. And if you want to learn more about the device, go to WPBF.com. Click the link under the As Seen on 25 section. We continue our coverage of the oil spill crisis now. Federal officials have confirmed that oil is seeping from the cap BP placed over the ruptured well last week. But the question now is, what's next? Well, for the next 24 hours, the cap will remain in place, although BP will be on alert for any more leaks. After that, who knows? BP wants to leave the cap on the well until the relief wells are finished, but the government wants to allow some oil to seep out and to be siphoned to the ships on the surface. Well, BP says that process to hook up the containment system again after letting some out would take 3 days and oil would gush into the Gulf the entire time.
Our scientists have warned us that there could be